Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Akash Kumar Singh, and I'm here to present my study that is comparative study on currency before and after demonetization. So let's move toward the demonetization. Let's know what it is. Demonetization is a monetary step in which a currency unit status as a legal tender is declared invalid. Or according to Investopedia, demonetization is the act of stripping a currency unit of its status as legal tender. Now, what is the meaning of legal tender? It is any official medium of payment recognized by law that can be used to extinguish a public or private debt or meet a financial obligation. Like, for example, now national currency of a country is considered legal tender, but on the other hand, Bitcoin is not considered so. So, in demonetization, it involves either introducing new notes or coins of the same currency or completely replacing the old currency with the new one. Like what India faced on 8 November 2016, we all know. So, basically, what is the reason behind such a government initiative? It to curb the menace of black money, is to solve the danger that like black money runs a parallel economy. And second one, to stop the counterfeit currency that is used or diverted to fund terrorist activities in the ground of India and to eradicate corruption that happens due to cash. Now, in this poster, we have done a comparative study on the currency notes of 50 rupees, 100 rupees note, and 500 rupees note, that what changes have been done in this three currency notes before and after demonetization. So let's know about Indian currency. Indian rupee is the official currency of the Republic of India. The issuance is given by the Reserve Bank of India, RBI, and the Indian currency have many security features. Some of them cannot be copied. So there are many security features. Security features are what that distinguish a fake currency note from the genuine one, like intaglio printing, optical variable ink, watermarks, etc. So in this paper, we have considered five security features. And first one is watermark, security thread, micro lettering, identification mark, and see-through register. So in 50 rupees currency notes, before demonetization, watermark was located toward left side of the portrait of Mahatma Gandhi. But after demonetization, it was towards right of the portrait. And in 100 rupees note, it was same, like it was before demonetization, it was located to a left side of the portrait of Mahatma Gandhi. But after demonetization, it was towards right. And the same was in 500 rupees note. The second feature is the security thread. The silver colored machine readable security thread in 50, 100 and 500 rupees note. Jo the security thread is located on the front side and is fully embedded on the reverse side. So before demonetization, in 50 rupees notes, the security thread was located towards left side, and after demonetization, it was toward right side of the portrait. And the same was done in 100 rupees as well as 500 rupees note. Now the third feature is the micro lettering. These features appears between the vertical band and Mahatma Gandhi's portrait. It contain word RBI and denominational value of the banknote. So it is difficult to view, so it can be seen by magnifying glass or microscope. So before demonetization, in 50 rupees note, RBI, Reserve Bank of India, and 50 was printed before demonetization. But after demonetization, India, Bharat was printed on 50 rupees note. And in 100 rupees note before demonetization, RBI 100 was printed, but after India Bharat has been printed. And in 500 rupees note, RBI 500 was printed before demonetization, and after demonetization, India Bharat has printed. So let's move to the fourth, that is identification mark. This helps blind people to identify the note, and its value are printed from side of note in intaglio print, means in raised form, so that they can feel it after touching, and has different shapes. It has been given different shapes for different denomination. For example, like in bef sorry for before demonetization, in 50 rupees note, square print was a square mark was printed, identification mark. But after demonetization, it was absent. Nothing mark was, no marks was present like identification mark. And in 100 rupees note, triangular mark was printed before demonetization. But after demonetization, now it has there are four angular bead lines on the notes. And in 500 rupees note before demonetization, a circular identification mark was present. But after demonetization, five angular bead line can be seen. Last is the see-through register. On the left side, the accurate back makes the numerical value appear as one when viewed under the light. So when the note is held up to the light, the parts of design printed on the back will fit exactly within unprinted areas on the front to produce complete design. So before demonetization, so this denomination was enclosed in a floral design in 50 rupees note. But after demonetization, there was no floral design. It was, the denomination was printed as such. And in 100 rupees note, the same has been done, like the denomination was printed in floral, enclosed in floral design, but after demonetization, it was not enclosed in any design, and the same has been done in 500 rupees note. So the moving toward the conclusion, the paper study of detailed information about the various distinct security features that are embedded in the original Indian currency notes of the denominational value 50, 100 and 500, which are easy to recognize and can be easily identified and observed with the naked eyes. Every individual must have knowledge about these security features in order to prevent the counterfeiting of currency notes. Thank you.